But they all do sort of the same thing, and that is rearrange what you thought was real. And they remind you of the beauty of very simple things. You forget, because you're so busy going from A to Z, that there's 24 letters in between. Letters in between. Letters in between. Letters.
America and the world is under attack. They're using terrorism and the fear of terrorism. Because the government's telling us, give up our liberty for security. But throughout history, anybody that gives up liberty gets tyranny.
There's not one thing the government can do to solve this problem. They don't have the intelligence and they don't have the methodology. People are hopeful, they're desperate, and they're fearful, and they'll hang on to anything. When people lose everything, and they have nothing left to lose, they lose it.
I'm going to see food riots, tax protests, farmer rebellions, student revolts, squatter diggings, homeless uprising, tent cities, ghost malls are already popping up, general strikes, war snappings, kidnappings, and mob rule and terror.
Every nightmare the old timers ever talked about is now happening.
If you don't resist, it's only going to get worse. It's not going to get better. It was once better. So I just want this kind of to be a message from the past, and the future people hear this. I'm sorry that we didn't fight hard enough for you, and I'm sorry that we didn't do everything we could.
I'm always amazed that people would listen to the people that didn't see it coming to say what's going to happen next.
The point is, we've got to speak out. We've got to say no.
The world is like a ride at an amusement park. And when you choose to go on it, you think it's real, because that's how powerful our minds are. And we can change it anytime we want. It's only a choice. Choice right now. Between fear and love.
The way it could change is when people regain their dignity and self-respect. That's when it's going to change, when they realize that they have it within them to take the information that's in there, find out who they really are, what their base greatest talents are, and put that to work.
We're writing the history of the future.
What we hope they do with the information is to take proactive measures, to understand what the future looks like so that they can redesign and reprogram to get to where they need to go.
Now, this very moment, nothing mystical, just now, very simple, straightforward. And from that nowness, however, arises a sense of intelligence, always, that you are constantly interacting with the reality, one by one, spot by spot, constantly. We actually experience fantastic precision always, but we are threatened by the now, so we jump to the past or the future. Everything we experience are unconditional experience.